Patty Steele, Last Time Around.
Oh, it's a good day, singing a song, and it's a good day, we're moving along. Yes, it's a good day, how could anything go wrong? A good day from morning till night. Yes, it's a good day, for shining your shoes, and it's a good day, for losing the blues. Everything to gain and nothing to lose, cause it's a good day from morning till night.
You're right!
Transmitting live and direct from the Mothership Studios for the last time, it's the Big Show on the air everywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the greatest city in the world,
New York, New York.
It's the Thursday, almost Friday, Big Show on CBS-FM, New York.
What else would you expect?
Scott Shannon and the Big Show.
3, 2, 1.
On CBS-FM.
6:08, 8 minutes after 6 a.m. Hello, it's Thursday, December the 15th, 2022. And if you're wondering why we're calling this the last official Big Show, we want to get all the reminiscing and all the tears and all the things we have to do out of the way today.
Yep, I hear you.
Because tomorrow is
We're not allowed to reminisce or tear up.
Right. It's a day of celebration, Patty.
Of course.
And of course, to record this monumental event today,
mm-hmm.
Radio's best friend, Art Vuolo. You probably heard about this guy. His home base, his warehouse of operations is in Detroit, Michigan. And,
oh, beautiful Detroit.
And he travels around and he records things that happen in radio. And I've known him for quite some time. He's recorded me at numerous radio stations. I'm like a gypsy.
Yeah, he's been pretty much omnipresent since I was
in my
early 20s.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen him.
His work is in the Radio Hall of Fame and all the other halls of fame, so...
Yeah.
He was at. He was even at the latest induction when Mad Dog went in.
And Broadway Bill.
Broadway Bill Lee, yeah. Right there in front of him.
Yep, exactly.
The thing that's kind of confusing about, not confusing, but it makes it difficult for us because this is our last regular radio show.
Mm-hmm.
And it's my last career show.
Yeah.
From CBS-FM. I leave that door open just in case.
I know. You've been there before.
Everybody,
right?
Go.
Yeah, we've heard that.
I talked to a guy yesterday from Newsday, and he said, "You know, you don't know this, but I've been following you, and I don't trust you." That's what he said. He doesn't trust me. He says, "I have a funny feeling I'm going to be hearing from you again in 2023.
He never goes away.
I said, "No."
Remember that.
I said, "You're not going to hear from me for a while. I just want to take a little time off.
Make it not too long."
Yeah, you know, they'll forget you.
Yeah, yeah.
So we got that going.
Yeah.
We got to discuss that. And we're looking back at our 8.5 years at CBS-FM this morning.
Now, do you want me to tell you what stories are going on today? I don't know what you want.
No, just hang out.
You don't want any headlines?
No, go ahead if you want to. I don't care.
Sure.
It's our last show. How bad is that going to be?
And you can tell how well planned it is.
Go ahead.
Interest rates up again, a pain in the butt if you're buying or selling a house.
Merry New York Christmas.
CBS-FM. Last time around, Big Show at 6:30. Tomorrow morning we'll be in Valhalla, New York. Broadcasting from Blythedale Children's Hospital, as we always do.
Mm-hmm.
That's another thing that's on my mind today.
What?
It's our last party for the kids at Blythedale.
Well, maybe, maybe not.
Well,
maybe they'll invite us back and we can do a show that doesn't go on the radio.
That's going to sound great, Patty. Thank you for that idea.
We can all pretend.
Yeah. We look back and it was March 3rd, 2013, when the Big Show officially signed on the air.
2014.
I'm sorry, 2014. I thought it was 2013.
And I joined March 26. I remember that because it's my son's birthday.
And then Brad slid in between it in the, on the 6th. That was your first.
Day four. It's like, it's very biblical.
Yeah. Day four.
March 3rd, 2014, the Big Show began its run here. What is it, just over 8.5 years? We're looking at 9.
Yeah, almost. It's 8. Yeah, it'd be 9 in 2 months. So
it was a fascinating week because I turned up on the Thursday and I see, Scott, you're in full flight already by day four. And you've got Joe Nolan sitting there. It's like, yeah. And then,
you felt like you stepped back in time.
What the heck is going on?
Wait a minute. What am I? Am I on 95.5 or 101.1?
That was... It was really good.
That was funny.
It's wonderful.
By the way, this morning, over on Channel 5, there's a special event going on.
Oh, yeah. Our friend Robert Moses came in. He did an amazing piece with us talking about kind of a retrospective on Scott's career. And so they ran it early this morning on Channel 5 and they at 4:40. They ran it again at 6:20, but you can catch it again at 8:40.
It's on Good Day New York.
So maybe we can share it somehow.
Now, you're saying it's a phenomenal... Have you seen it?
No, I...
You're guessing that he does good work.
I think he does good work because he is so smart and he has such an incredibly warm heart. He's just a really terrific young guy. And he was so anxious to capture everything about this show. And, so I'm going to believe that.
All right. No, that's what you do. You believe.
How would I have seen it? Who am I? I don't get that.
No, I just wonder how you knew it was so great. I hope you're right.
The stuff from yesterday was spectacular.
Mm. I was all over the place.
That News Nation one, I'm like, who is this News Nation mob?
I don't know.
It's like the most incredible package.
Art, have you heard of News Nation?
I know the guy that runs it.
Who is that?
Sean Compton.
Yeah. Mm.
News Chicago.
I remember him from many years ago. He was a...
And where do you get News Nation?
On the cable.
On cable?
Yeah. It's on there. Yeah. It's pretty good. It's pretty
really
well
good.
Done, yeah.
And that young guy interviewing you was lapping you up, Scott. He was good, that young kid.
They didn't know who they were. They had no idea.
No,
who
you
I
ran
was.
Rings around him, though.
But they did a good job. And then I went over to our sister station, The Fan, because, you know... And Patty always watching me. You're doing too much sports. And I just like sports.
Well, I don't say that. The bosses said that to you.
And you remind me. You just remind me.
Just because I don't know what you're talking about because I'm not a sports person.
You can't talk about sports. Nobody else on the show knows about it but you. So,
well, the irony of that is, Scott, you went over there and actually didn't talk about sports and just put on a full-on comedy show.
He comes here and talks about sports, and then he goes there and talks.
Jesus,
well,
good work.
I'm a little confused, Patty.
Okay, yeah. Chris Oliveira's listening, going, "Geez, maybe we shouldn't have." Look at this retirement a little bit.
I asked him not to talk sports that earlier.
This guy was amazing.
I got confused. I thought he was looking over my shoulder. Don't talk. Wait a minute. I'm on The Fan now. Yeah. I can talk sports.
But you didn't talk sports. You just were hilarious. It was pure comedy.
And I met the two guys who do the warm up show. You ever heard that one, Brad?
Yeah, L. Jukes and Jerry Recco.
Yeah, they were there.
Yeah.
Jerry Recco, that guy's he works so hard.
He sounded nervous to meet you.
Yeah, he travels around. He's hardly ever, and they have this intro, and it goes, now it's a warm-up show with Jerry and Al, and most days they don't suck. And it bothers me when they introduce the show, so he starts talking while the guy's still doing doesn't suck. I said, you're going to let the suck word come out there. Anyway, this morning he dedicated it to me, and he didn't talk over the word suck. 6:35, Patty's in here. She has the early morning brain buster. It's all about the Big Show, and it's good for tickets to see Janet Jackson at the Garden.
Who was the first weatherman / meteorologist on our show here at CBS-FM?
Yep. He's our first guy. Wonderful man.
Yeah.
He just, him and me just didn't get along.
No. Physically fit. A physically fit man.
Yeah, you think?
We did well. Patty, I tried. You know that. I tried to make it work.
We've got an example of that coming up later in the show, Patty.
Oh, okay, yeah. Of how he really brought him along.
Not that much later in the show.
It was a heck of a handbrake.
Was he there for about 4 months here with us?
I don't know. It seemed like longer.
Yeah.
It's CBS-FM. My name is Scott. I've worked here for almost 9 years. I'm going to walk out of here today. My office clean.
A free man.
Ready for the next guy. A fella by the name of John Fox. And we're very familiar with
him. Yeah, he was on the country station here, and he was the PD there.
Yep, and he was also the afternoon guy over at, he worked with us over at PLJ.
And the program director there.
Yeah, yeah. He took my place there, and he's going to take my place here.
That's weird.
Forgot about that part, didn't you?
You better think about where you're going next.
Yeah, just make sure John Fox is worth hovering.
Does he follow you?
He's a good guy.
He's a sweetheart.
And he's going to do a great job. Give him a chance, if you would. 6:40, we got Franklin from Queens, and he wants to talk to Patty Steele.
Well, who doesn't? Hi, Franklin.
How you doing, Patty Steele?
Yeah, I told you.
Wow. Even remember
I'm
my last
the radio.
Name. Yes, you are on the radio. You got to tell us.
The answer.
Who was the first weatherman on our show here at CBS-FM?
Mr. G.
Mr. G. And Mr. G outlasted us. He's still on TV.
There you go.
All right. 11, right.
We have a little laugh over him, but he survives.
Yeah, that's the funny thing about it is he wears those, he's got these sport coats, and I think he used to weigh more, and since he lost the weight, looks like he lost about 25 pounds because he's a runner.
Yeah, he is.
And the sport coats go out like, they're like, he liked the movie Big, remember that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Not that big.
Not to that extent, frankly.
You're look at you making friends on the way out the door.
So, Brad, I think, didn't this involve the World Cup back then?
Yeah, we had a big show party at the Australian pub to watch Australia versus Holland in the World Cup. And
right.
We all went along and got a booth there, and it was very exciting. And Mr. G even turned up and joined us.
Wait a minute.
Mr. G.
Joe was there.
Joe Nolan.
Set the table.
Yep.
Patty, you were there.
Yep,
yeah,
Patty.
Yeah.
Kermit the Wonder Frog was there. Trevor.
Yep.
And myself, and then Mr. G stormed in a little bit later.
Here we go with the whole story.
Jeez. How long were you there yesterday for the big Australian
game? I was there for a good solid 6 hours.
Shannon and Patty were making us happy since March of 2014. Riding around with the big show on for my morning routine. John Elliott and Joe Nolan. Sue Ellerand, Brad Blanks kept us rolling. Kermit the Wonder Frog is out of his mind. Oh, but now we're here waving Shannon and Patty goodbye. Oh, oh, oh. They were on CBS and it's anyone's guess why the big show has come to an end. I know they desire that although they retire, they remain in the closest of friends. They're the king and the queen of the radio scene, and I hope that we hear them again. Whoa, whoa. That's all I heard about Shannon and Patty. It's the end of the show and we're all pretty sad. And here we are waving Shannon and Patty goodbye. So sad for me to see him go. Cause I'm a P1 person for the big show. Now for the last time, you know it's true. When the DJ says bye, buckaroos.
At CBS-FM.
At CBS-FM, you know what? You know what we have at CBS-FM?
What do you have?
We have a special... You know, I know how much you love surprises.
Yeah.
So we have a very special surprise guest. He did your show at Z100 when you first arrived in New York City. You know who it is? Take a guess. You didn't have that many guests. Nobody wanted to do the show.
Not Joey Reynolds.
It is Joey Reynolds.
Famous world DJ.
He is a New York City icon. Are you kidding?
Yeah. Oh. I used to come to work and listen to him. He was over on WOR.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that the station you were on?
Yeah, it's one of them.
He's like me. He hops from station to station around town.
He was also on
WABC.
He was on WNBC for a while.
And WNBC.
Yeah, that was a big deal. Troy Reynolds got his start up in Buffalo. Well, he'd been around before that, but he was very famous because they had a 50,000-watt radio station.
Yes.
And now he's got his own business going. What kind of cakes do you specialize in? I know it's a big hit.
You surprised me because I wasn't going to plug my cheesecake, but I just did.
Oh, yeah. Cheesecake.
I brought Scott the fame. I made a cheesecake for church because the food was so terrible. and I made it, and the women loved it. And the next week, I went back, and they said, more cheesecake. I forgot how I made it.
Oh, no.
So I had to ad-lib.
Yeah.
Scott and I have been ad-libbing our lives.
Yes. Well, then you hit the big time.
I did. We sold it at Bloomingdale's.
Wow.
And then the factory caught on fire.
Oh, what?
A little Joey Lightning.
Yeah. Jeez.
I got the thing on the market now. Yeah. But, you know, Scott.
What if somebody wanted to buy one of your cheesecakes? What would they do?
You just go to JoeyReynoldsCheesecake.com. Listen to me. I have to get even with you. You and I, I know you forgot this. I love Scott, incidentally, you know.
Yes, I see that.
He is the consummate last great program director, for one thing. And then as a disc jockey, you know, I came here today because I heard there was an opening.
Right.
It's already been filled, Joey. You could have had that if you'd been here earlier.
You might need a sidekick,
about
though.
15 years earlier. But Scott, listen to me. You and I were on with Oprah.
Right.
You remember that?
Yeah.
Did you forget that? And you, I was introduced as the first shock jock, and she said all these wonderful things about me. And then she asked Scott, "What do you think?" And he says, "Yeah, you know, he put me under the bus."
No, I didn't. We were on Oprah. I said, "He's funny."
Yeah, no, you...
He's
you,
funny. Eh.
Yeah. He's kind of funny. Yeah. Maybe I said he's kind of funny. I don't know.
Why are you leaving here? This is a good job.
It's a long story, Joey.
I don't think we want to get into it right here.
Go on the fan and tell it.
This is not exactly the place where
it's
I want
it. It's not a funny story.
Joey learned some stuff from Oprah, didn't you, Joey?
Good job. Let's hear it from Joey Reynolds, ladies and gentlemen. JoeyReynoldsCheesecake.com. You will love it. It's the big show.
Well, it's a funny game, isn't it, radio? Because it's a beautiful thing to get two bites of an amazing apple. So I loved my PLJ years, Scott. I walked in off the street and ran into you, and you sort of touched me on the head and anointed me with some kind of magic, and I lasted 10 years with you the first go round, and then the fact that I got to do another 9 years with you.
That was a bonus. You never thought you'd see me again.
No, that's right.
I know. I did three incarnations
with
him. That's
right. And the last 9 years have been very pleasurable. It's been a more mature approach. I'm a father. I got three kids. I got to put Harvey on the radio as a little boy, a little kid,
and
so
Scott's
thank you.
More mature, isn't he?
So thanks to Scott and Patty.
I'm
thank
the
you.
Same it's, idiot.
It's been a great fun time. You said you wanted to do more of the Ellen DeGeneres type show, an upbeat,
kinder,
positive,
gentler show. Positive.
And it's been a positive show with
Minus
great people
the
in the studio.
Toxic backstage.
That's
atmosphere.
Right.
Thank you.
I'm retiring. She's not.
You may not be.
How long?
Hold yourself to
I
that.
I don't know. Coming up, we'll examine her history on the radio. You'll hear her first tapes ever.
Yikes.
First air checks ever, as they call it in the business. I'll never forget the first time that I sat behind this control board.
Mm-hmm.
Patty was not on board yet. She waited, she wish-washed back and forth.
I teased you for three or four weeks, yeah.
Said, for God's sakes, make up your mind, will you?
That's what my husband kept saying.
For God's sakes, make up your mind, will you? This is a chance of a lifetime.
Only there were some expletives in his delivery.
I was a little bit nervous because it's funny because I knew an engineer. He used to, I think either him or his dad used to be, him or his son used to be the engineer for Cousin Brucey when he was at on Sirius XM.
Okay.
So I ran into this engineer one day, and I knew he worked at CBS-FM.
Right.
So I said, you tell your boss, that Joey guy, was it Joe McCoy, that someday I'm going to be over there playing the songs. Because I've always loved the old, you know, 60s and 70s music.
Right.
Even if it was before my time, I would study it and I would, you know, put it in my collection.
Well, 70s wasn't before.
No, 70. I'm not trying to act that way, but some of the late 50s and things like that before discovered music.
Right, right.
And Joe McCoy actually called me one day and says, "You call me when you're ready. I'll be over there. You come on over."
Oh.
And then he was already gone by the time I got here, but that was mm-hmm. the old sounding CBS-FM. Now we, you know, we start in the 80s and maybe a few in the late 70s.
Mm-hmm.
And let's go to Patty for a second, the history of Patty Steele. You were in love with radio from the very beginning.
Well, funny enough, I didn't fall in love with radio.
But you were in school.
I was in college, and I had a wicked crush on this guy who said to me, "You should come down and work at the radio station." I went, "Okay." Isn't that funny how something gets you? He turned out to be a loser, but I stayed with the radio, which was not a loser
for
me.
So you found a winner and a loser.
I'm a little nervous as to what you're going to hear here because I sound like I'm 14 years old, and I also want to make sure.
You might have been.
You have to leave space at the end of this tape for what comes next for me because it's not the end, even though
I think everyone listening knows that you're not retiring.
I don't know. And then people call up and say, "Happy retirement."
Well, they're talking to me, not you on that one. Then they go and say, "I love you, Patty."
Yeah.
The thing about it is too, you've left out the part that she grew up in the tri-state area here.
Yes.
And she actually was an intern in the glory days of 77 WABC.
Last year.
She worked for one of the greatest disc jockeys to ever crack a microphone.
Yeah.
Dan Ingram.
Yeah, he gave me my first, he listened to, weirdly, this tape and said, You're going to be an insider in this business. He said, "You're really good." And I remember thinking, how does he know that? I was a baby. And it was really...
I think he might have had some other things on his mind.
No, he was always incredibly supportive encouraging.
Well, you were always cute, though.
Well, you know, hey, mm-hmm. you got to use what you got,
use
baby.
What you got. So, as we go backwards for the history of Patty Steele.
It's a deserted island.
Uncharted. Look, down there. What's going on?
Oh, jeez.
I don't believe it. Coming out of the ocean, it's...
An island of rock at your fingertips. WTPC 89.7 FM.
It's Sweet Baby James on request to WTPC from back in 1976. Shower the people you love with love. This is also on request. Got a few good ones here. Nice and mellow.
They got that sped up, Patty.
When I need you. You got a request? Give me a call at 295 at Ross Campus. Call me at 374-2872. You know I'd love to hear from you. Got heavy storm warnings out for you tonight. That was the Lido Shuffle, by the way, by Boz Skaggs. Heavy storm warnings tonight. Cloudy tonight with snow beginning late. Low tonight in the low 20s. Snow all the way through tomorrow with accumulations of 4 to 6 inches expected. Turning to freezing rain at times. High tomorrow, 32 degrees. Low of 20 degrees.
Lord.
Snow should be ending tomorrow night. Clear and colder on Thursday. High around 30 degrees. Clear and warmer on Friday. A high of 38 degrees. Right now, winds are out of the northwest.
You know what you need there?
26 degrees outside, which means it's -3 degrees on the Celsius scale. Here's the Bee Gees again, staying alive from Saturday Night Fever.
Listen to her talk up the song.
ABA Arlington, Washington, Virginia, and Maryland's All Hit 105, where every day is payday.
Oh, she's starting to get good now. Here she comes.
Oh, we're doing 45 minutes of nonstop music, and this is a delicious song for 2 o'clock in the morning. Love and touchy, smooth and journey on WAVA.
That's a pretty good station there.
105 WAVA. All hit 105 WAVA. Hey, you be listening for Dancing in the Dark from the Boss. When it plays, we pay $105. It's the payday song. This is the brand new one from the Commodores, Night Shift. We all know about that, huh? Good morning. It's 35 degrees at 9:03. I'm Patty Steele with a Z100 information update.
Supposed to be 55 for the high tomorrow. I like it today. I like this.
Oh, Patty, you would like these gray, rainy days.
Well, once in a while, it's okay.
All right, so what's going on with E on the Z, Patty?
Well, you might try dressing up as Madonna. She's back. She's looking impossibly dirty. And, boy, she's opening her stint at Madison Square Garden Thursday. She's wearing a lot of naughty clothes. Have you seen any of this stuff from her?
Oh, yes. She borrowed half of them from me.
Yeah, well, if you want a preview of it, tomorrow night she's going to be hosting a private party to which Elvis was invited but turned down the invitation.
It's going to be too crowded. I get nervous in crowds.
Okay, it's going to be at the China Grill tomorrow night. Now, true to form, she probably won't arrive till very late. She'll leave again within 45 minutes, so stake yourself outside if you want to look at her. By the way, the wild clothes for the tour were designed and made by two Italian designers who, between them, made 1,500 costumes for this show.
How much money did they make?
They made nothing. They said they have not billed her, and she has not asked for a bill, and they like it that way.
Listen. About
what?
These Madonna parties.
Yeah.
You feel like a very, very important person when you're invited, but when you get there, they won't let you anywhere near her.
Oh, really?
So why go? I'm going to stay home and just, you know, watch.
They have a part of the China Grill roped off, and she stands back there and kisses her girlfriend,
exactly.
And you watch.
There's a big sign up in neon that says, Elvis is not allowed in this section. So why bother with it? What's next, Patty?
I have a sign like that at home.
WCBS News Time, 7 o'clock. Jets have a new head coach and a new consultant. The Crown Heights civil rights case goes to the jury tomorrow. Good evening. I'm Patty Steele. From the WCBS Weather Center, we are expecting breezy conditions tonight with rain and fog becoming heavy at times. Temperatures on the rise. Right now we have light rain falling, and it's 36 degrees in New York. WCBS News Time, 7:05.
7:07 at CBS-FM. Patty driving solo while my pal Scott Shannon is out. And I love this. I just found out he's going to be the flower girl at this wedding he went to up in Massachusetts.
You know what? That makes sense.
I so need that photo. How adorable will he be in that little fluffy dress?
I'm sure. He looks lovely in tulle.
You know, he is a fashionista. You know, every morning, he can't wait to hook up with you, Dean, on his iPad so he can look at what you're wearing.
Always judges
every
my
morning.
Hair. He's like, did you get a haircut yet? I'm like, yes, I got one.
So we're going to try to get pictures of him in the flower girl dress, and we'll post that.
Or at least a little flower in his ear. A little orchid just hanging out.
That's so him.
101.1 CBS FM.
Wow. There you go.
Jeez.
What a career.
I don't know how I managed to last in this business.
Go on back. Let me hear that. Start that
no,
over.
No, don't you dare.
I got to hear that again. Put it on there.
That was amazing.
Are you
that
sure that tape? That sounds like you sound like Alvin or one of the chipmunks.
I know. It does sound stale.
Hold on a minute.
It's a deserted island.
Oh, God.
I got to sit through that.
You got to sit through that. You don't want to sit through this.
What's going on?
Oh, jeez.
I don't believe it. Coming out of the ocean, it's...
An island of rock.
Here she comes.
At your fingertips. WTPC.
I wonder if that was the guy I liked.
Wow.
FM.
Sweet Baby James on request to WCBS from back in 1976. Shower the people you love with love. This is also
were you able to buy beer then?
actually, no. Not even close. This was years before beer.
I don't think your daughter's ever sounded like that since she was out of diapers.
Now you listen to Heather and you think, wow, look how deep her voice is.
I'm going to get there, Scott.
What you got to do is you got to carry that tape with you and say, you think I'm high, listen to this girl.
Exactly.
That's it was
amazing.
Sped up. It had to have been
holy
sped
cow.
Up. Except the music doesn't sound sped up, so.
No, that's what's weird
work.
About it. That's what they used to do. They used to speed the records up. They could play more, songs.
Yeah,
so
not on
they
a college
had you
station.
Sped up on that station. What's the name of that station?
WTPC.
No. Home of the babies.
Baby DJs.
No doubt about exactly. It. CBS FM. Happy holidays. The big show is on. Last time around, direct from the home studios. It's our last show here.
Mm-hmm.
We started in this operation. What was it? Say 2013? Was that it?
2014.
March.
He's trying to stretch it.
May. I'd like to get to 9 years, but it's eight and change.
Well, it's 9 seasons.
Yeah.
9 seasons.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Exactly.
The
unless
show,
we did 2 a year.
This used to be a show, but now it's like a party going on.
Right.
Trish and Kathleen rolled in here from from Westchester County. They brought a whole tray of Christmas cookies and everything.
Man, those are dangerous.
And then the Patty family rolled in here.
Yep.
They got Will. It's only one missing. Where's Jake?
He's in Colorado. Couldn't come back for this.
Will looks like he just slept over here on the way.
And my baby brother, Dave Plotkin, is also here.
All right. So, and there's all kind of action going on. Yeah. Our old producer, Andre, slid by this morning. He's here. And I just found out that a friend of ours is here. This guy was a listener of Z100. And the first time he ever called the station, he was 5 years old. His name is Eric Nagel, but at that time, he decided since he was five, he couldn't say his own name. So he called in, I said, who is it? It's Eric Nagel. And I thought he was saying Eric Noogie. And then you told me you were 25 or something?
Yeah, I thought you had to be an adult to call the radio station, so I lied and thought I got away with it, and then,
you did okay till I asked you a question.
Oh, yeah.
I said, Mr. Noogie, what kind of car are you driving? He says, a Ford Mercury. Well, that's two different cars.
Maybe he had two cars.
Was that the first time you ever called, or the first time you admitted it?
I think that was the first time I got through. Yeah. Where, because as a little kid, like, wow, they're giving out the phone number. I know how to use the phone now. I can talk to somebody on the radio.
I'm 5 years old, so I swear to God, it was one of the funniest phone calls ever. It's Eric Noogie. I said, he could. I thought you were making that up, but he was trying to say his name, Nagel. And he couldn't.
Yeah.
And can you say it now?
Barely.
And Z100 inspired you to get into radio.
Well, it was that station, but it all goes to you. You were pretty much the driving force. I was like, I could make a career talking on the radio and saying funny and dumb things. And I was like, all right, this is what I want to do. And I figured out how to do it.
Dumb?
Yeah. So then he got started with Opie and Anthony. He's the one that came up with that church, St. Patrick's promotion, right?
No. That was not my idea. I actually worked at PLJ for a tiny bit.
While I was there?
Yeah.
Oh,
96 through 98. I was an intern there.
Were you still Noogie?
No. But I think I used to have to, sometimes if I was there in the morning, I'd have to go to your office and get your Diet Dr. Pepper. You'd be in the studio by yourself and nobody was around. It's like, go into my office, get my Diet Dr. Pepper. And that's pretty much what I had to do for Scott.
That was your gig, huh? and then after it was Opie and Anthony, I came over here and I got a text from him. He said, they want to put you on the air. I said, what do you think? I'm crazy. I'm not going on with Opie and Anthony.
I had to talk this guy like it was traumatic stress. And Jim Norton, the comedian on our show, realized 1 year that, yes, we were focusing on the wrong person.
They were destroying. They remember that?
The boat movie, the battery car, there's a tree on my house, all these little intersectulars that you would spit out there that were hilarious because they were used out of context. And we realized, like, oh, it's the other thing that's the issue with this show, not Scott.
The other thing.
And
so
that's
they figured out who they really hated.
That's when the tide turned, the public opinion swayed, and when I finally convinced him to come on the show, it was gangbusters. He blew them away, and the audience went 100% Team Scott. They were making their own merchandise. They had Team Scott shirts. They had signs at other events.
When we first signed on, there was a big jump in the ratings, and most of it were, a lot of them were Opie and Anthony listeners and people who came with us because at that time PLJ had a big ship anchor on it.
Whoa. Yeah.
But anyway, I'm glad you showed up. I'm glad you made me do the interview.
Yeah. I am too. It was one of the...
it was wonderful.
It was one of the best things that we could have done for you launching your time here at CBS-FM. And it's just been fantastic.
What are you going to do for us next?
we're going to talk off air.
Yeah.
We've got some stuff
Eric
lined up.
Noogie, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Scott.
Oh, my God. I think we're okay now. Good to go, Brad?
Yeah, I think you're good now.
I'm back on the train.
WCBS-FM and WCBS-FM HD1.
I love the music.
Celebrating 50 years of New York's greatest hits.
The greatest hits of all time.
Scott, it's your old friend John Bon Jovi. Congratulations on nearly 40 years of rocking the radio.
You've done a lot for me, for the band, for the Soul Kitchen. Hell, you've been my dad's golf buddy. Appreciate you, man. Looking forward to hearing about your next chapter. And I want to thank you for all the incredible work that you've done at the Blythedale Children's Hospital. I hope you guys are having a wonderful morning. Happy holidays, everybody.
That guy's been a part of our show for quite some time. Always generous with his time. And, of course, the work that he does for people who need help.
Yeah.
Amazing. Mm-hmm. Thank you, John. And direct, live and direct into the Mothership Studios, one of our old pals. He was a big star on American Idol. He was a big star on America's Got Talent. I thought Heidi Klum was going to wrap him up and take him home.
Take a bite.
They call him The Voice. He is Sal Valentinetti. Good morning,
woo!
Buddy.
Hey.
Good morning, Scott. Good morning, Patty. Good morning, Brad. Louie. How you guys doing?
Awesome, Sal.
You know, I tried. Your father would not answer his damn phone. I called him time after time. I tried to call your mother.
What were you trying to get?
You want to know, Scott? You want to know? I get a call one night from my father. And I very late at night, and it's not very typical of him. And I answer the phone, and I go, Dad, what's going on? He said, I think Scott Shannon is trying to call me. But I'm not sure.
He didn't believe
that you were actually trying to call him, Scott. You don't understand the brevity of a phone call from Scott Shannon. It left him perplexed and flustered.
I do have a short attention span, but I had been dialing that number. I thought I had the wrong number, and I dialed and dialed because what happened was pretty embarrassing. He and your mom made a big donation to Blythedale Children's Hospital about 2 years ago.
Oh, this is the check you found.
And I'm going through my files, and I found the check. Because you know how crazy it gets out there.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to let him know to say thank you, and I don't know what happened to the money.
Oh my lord!
I'm guessing that they found out the check didn't clear. I won't get into all that.
This is something.
If he ever returns my call, I'll give him the whole information.
Well, you let me know so I can write two checks because the work you do for Blythedale Children's Hospital is really incomparable, Scott. You know your influence spans far beyond just about every car, construction site, and office. In the tri-state area, it goes straight to these kids, and you see it every year with your Blythedale fundraiser. You really are an angel. The New York is going to be really 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 sorry without you.
Well, I appreciate that, but I got to tell you something. That the people who work in that hospital, as you know from being there, are very special, and it's almost like it's a big family there.
Oh, it's totally a family.
We always say, Patty, that you can't tell the people who work there from the parents of the
kids.
No,
because there's such joy and such love in the way that they deal with those little ones. And the little ones are so happy and joyous. It sounds like it would be a depressing place to go. It couldn't be further from the truth. It is a beautiful...
It's the happiest.
Isn't it?
Patty, absolutely right. Yeah. It's the happiest, most joyous occasion of the Christmas season. It's to see just the love and the warmth on everyone's faces that the parents and the families can forget about what's going on for a day.
Right. You are listening to the man they call The Voice, Sal Valentinetti. Now, you're in California, and I appreciate you getting up this early to call us.
Yeah.
You really, I mean, there's not enough good things I could say about you.
You're going to keep going until I start crying, you know that? I'm not going to do it. It's too early in the show.
You got a few minutes, Scott.
All I want you to know, we love you, buddy, and we'll see you soon. CBS-FM, last time around. Got a guy checking in today. A deli man from Connecticut. His name is Tony. Morning, Tony.
Good morning, Scott. How are you?
You ran the Firehouse Deli, but I think your son's running it now, right?
He is, and I'm back here right now in the kitchen with him. Hold on.
Hello?
Hey, man. Is that your dad?
Yes, it is. He's the best. I'm lucky.
Now, you're running the whole deal now.
That's right.
You know, I sneak in there every so often. I have to say, do you? I have to say hi.
Make sure you say hello next time you're in, just so I can buy you a nice sandwich.
No, I'm not like that. I'm not a don't-you-know-who-I-am kind of guy.
Yeah.
His dad checked in. His dad's got that kind of Sopranos voice.
Oh, yeah.
If you know what I'm talking about.
How you doing?
He's got that kind of voice.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks again to our friend Robert Moses and everybody over Good Day New York. That was really a nice piece they put on this morning. We didn't get to see the whole thing, but we saw a little bit of it on TV, actually, because we're doing a show here.
I taped it, so I will send it to you, too.
Thank you.
Our Anthony McCaffrey has written to just say how much he loves us and how he's... wishes us. I'm gonna get emotional. he's been coming up to see us for what 22
oh,
years?
Oh man,
at least 22 years, probably more than that.
His mother used to bake cookies for us.
She baked cookies for us. He was the
birthday. He was the
bus driver rodeo.
Yeah,
he won the bus driver rodeo in Vegas. Oh. He's the best, and he came up and he's just writing to tell us how much he loves us.
Now we played the history of Patty Steele a little while ago.
Yes.
Mine is not quite as polished as hers, even with the little chipmunk boys.
But it's a lot longer.
Well, yeah, I was
been around a little longer.
I started a while. And I think this is the first station I was ever on.
Right.
And this tape, this air check, I found it in the basement, in a box that's been put away. It's never been played on the air since it was on the air.
Since it was on, right.
It's the first time, so keep that in mind. And
you're making excuses for you, but I sounded like a chipmunk.
Well, you did.
I did.
There's no
a cute one, though. Very cute.
Yes. Guilty.
You'll have plenty of time to work on me after this.
Okay.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Scott Shannon Show.
WCBS-FM. WABB.
Yeehaw, pick up on it. Shooby dooby 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 day is the name of the thing. Big. 908. WABB Mad Mad Button Time. Super Shan Radio Program. Happy birthday to David Jernigan. Dave is 15 years old today. Let's ring the birthday bell.
Ring that Super Shan birthday bell. Yes, sir. Rudy Tooty Tooty.
Hotel.
A box tops, a moving on. Coke after Coke after Coke.
Pick up on Coca-Cola and those handy one-way bottles, and you can earn valuable CCA points. Thank you.
Thank you.
All the WABB good guys say
thank you
for spelling rabbit with a W. We patrol the greater Port City area, giving away hundreds of prizes to those displaying WABB IT signs. Again,
thank you.
This is the Scott Shannon Program on Mobile's much more music station.
WABB.
9:30 in the Port City. Papa Paul Revere and the Raiders. The name of the song is Kicks. 9:46 WABB Mad Mad Button Time on the Scott Shannon Hit Pack Radio Program.
Radio News Headline.
Shannon with the 9:30 report. Governor Lester Maddox has lashed out against those he calls a group of unshaven, undeodorized, so-called disciples of peace and love who recently marched on the Pentagon to protest the Vietnam War.
WMAK Nashville.
9:00 in Music City. This is your Super Shan program.
WMAK.
Speaking of heavy music, tonight on the Power Hour, you can pick up on Blind Faith, Jimi Hendrix, Buffalo Springfield, the Grand Funk Railroad, and that brand new super heavy Mother Earth album recorded out at Mount Juliet. That's tonight for your head at 11 o'clock, my Power Hour. Now Junior Walker, the All-Stars, Market 15 from the MAK Super Summer Survey. This is What Does It Take to Win Your Love.
God,
WQXI, and the lion sleeps tonight. Daytime, he just sits around flicking his beak. Here now, 558, Quixie, from Shannon and War, with a cut from the Why Can't We Be Friends album.
WQXI, Atlanta.
Beatles cooking with Hey Jude at 606 from the Shannon program. The annual DeKalb County Fair is being held all this week at South DeKalb Mall. I don't know if they got all those bees rounded up or what happened to them in Stone Mountain. A bee truck turned over out there. It carries beehives. And now loose in the Stone Mountain area, 2 million bees.
WPGC presents Scott Shannon.
Good evening. How are you tonight? Shannon on the radio, and I'm feeling fine. 2 hours of memories, 2 hours of the best oldies you've ever heard, some of the stories behind them. Let's kick it off with a five-man electrical band.
WRBQ-FM Tampa. WRBQ-AM St. Petersburg. Q105, Tampa Bay's radio station.
Roll the tapes. It's time to go high above the city to those beautiful penthouse studios. The No Jive 105, the 100,000-watt flamethrower, where we find that always dapper rapper, the joy boy with the joy toy, the big boss with the big hot sauce, the man the can, the man with the plan, the daddy with the radio. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for that oldies hour. Guaranteed to be more glad in your stride, more soul in your stroll, and more pep in your step. The oldies hour is on the air everywhere. If I'm lying, I'm dying. And grits ain't groceries, eggs ain't poultry. And Mona Lisa lives in New York City.
Hello, Q105.
Collect from Ronald Reagan. Will you pay?
A collect phone call from Ronald Reagan? Yes, operator. I can pay now.
Well, I keep calling collect. I want to keep my expenses down here.
Why do you have a lot of money, Ronnie? I know you had made a lot of money from those Borax commercials and those Van Heusen commercials. And
General Electric, too. Don't forget General Electric.
General Electric. But why do you call me collect?
Well, I just thought I'd ask it one last time.
This is the last day, Ronald. You can't get me at this number. I got to give you a new number.
Well, that's what you sure you haven't changed your mind?
No, I haven't changed the line, so you won't call. I still like you. Even though you call collect and you bug me about leaving, I'm going to the Big Apple.
Today is the last day?
Today is it.
And you're going to split?
I'm going to split, Mr.
Radio Pat. Talk, this kind of jive, you know, get down.
Yeah, you used to be in radio, didn't you?
Well, yes, a long time ago, back in Iowa, WHO.
What were those 78 RPM records like?
Well, they weren't so bad. You had to wind up the turntable about 2.5 times, I think, to get it up to speed.
Have you told Nancy that I'm leaving?
Yes, and she's pretty upset.
She's mad, 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 huh?
Well, she says that you're going to be sorry because you're going to miss the sunshine of Florida.
I will miss that.
You're going to miss all the ocean breeze.
I'm going to miss that.
You're going to miss being able to walk on the beach.
I'm going to miss that.
You're going to miss a lot of things. You get back to New York and you're going to wind up getting mugged the first thing.
Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. Rise and shine with folks like you. Good morning from the Q Morning Zoo. Get up with the morning Q Zoo. Get up in the morning, get up in the morning, get up with the morning Q Zoo.
A lot of people might find this hard to believe, but over the past 2 years, I made an awful lot of good friends with people I've never even seen face-to-face, just people who call in on the telephone. And both young people, little baby DJs, as I like to call them.
Yeah, we're going to miss you a lot, no doubt about it.
Really?
I hope you do real, real well in New York.
Well, you know how tough it is up there. I'm going to try to pull it together. And I'm going to represent Q105 and all my buddies as well as I can. There have been a lot of guys who went up there and said they were going to do it and came back all beaten up and battered. And as a matter of fact, about 95% of them do that, don't they, Mason?
They sure do.
They all come back all skinned up. But if anybody can do it in the Big Apple, Scotty will do fine. As I was telling somebody, you know, when I was a little kid, I used to dream a lot. And then as I grew up, I found out that when you dream it, it's a dream. If you do it, it's not a damn dream anymore.
That's right.
And I got one more dream. And that's it.
And you'll be there probably tonight, starting work on it.
Serving the universe from the top of the Empire State Building, Z100. Get out of the way.
The Z Morning Zoo on Z100.
It's 8 minutes after 6 a.m., August the 2nd, 1983. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, radio station WHTZ signs on the air. WHTZ is owned and operated by Malrite Communications and broadcast at a frequency of 100.3 megahertz. Signing on the air, this is WHTZ.
Z100.
It's time to wake up.
The
Tuesday morning, Zoo. Spanky on Super Sticker Patrol, and good morning to you from the zoo. Who's this?
Hello?
Oh, no, never mind. I know who this is. Good morning, Mr. Leonard.
Well, good morning, Scott. Yes, it's me, Mr. Leonard, Assistant Public Service Director and Research Assistant.
You know, obviously you conveniently forgot the telephone conversation we had yesterday just around 12 noon.
Yeah, that one, which one was that?
The conversation when I had Dean Thacker in my office, when you said you would definitely make it into the radio station today in order to do the zoo with us?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but we didn't specify any specific time, Scott.
Right.
The telephone call that Dean Thacker commented on, that if you wanted to continue to collect a check from Mallright Broadcasting?
Yeah, but I thought the conversation was about my work, not my appearances. See, I'm doing work right now.
The Flamethrower, Z100.
The mothership has landed. Pirate Radio, 100.3 FM. Welcome to the jungle.
6:04 in the morning in Los Angeles, and now, ladies and gentlemen, live from the broken-down, low-rent, sleazy, double-greasy Pirate Radio Nut Hut Studios, it's time for the very first ever Southern California edition of the Shannon in the Morning Radio Spectacular and Entertainment Extravaganza, starring Michael Scott Shannon as the head pronunciator. Shannon in the Morning. If I'm lying, I'm dying. And grits ain't groceries, eggs ain't poultry, and Mona Lisa was a man.
From the capital of the universe.
On 95.5 PLJ.
It's the Big Show, 851. Scott and Todd, last time around. Quite frankly, this is the longest that I've ever had one job or lived in one place.
This was your second family. We were all kind of family.
Yeah, basically,
sure.
That's it. And, you know, we started in June of 1991. That's when we first met, and that's when we first started working together. And, like Jay Leno said last night, the greatest 22 and a half years of my life spent right here in this room with most of these people. And this is it today. I'm retiring from PLJ. I'm not retiring from life, and I'm not retiring from radio.
You got a lot of life in you.
But
you got a lot of golf balls to hit in the woods.
And people say, why? It's really not important why. It's just time. That's all it is. And I want to say thank you to my daughter, Kathleen, and my wife, Trish, for supporting me and being by my side. Joe Partavilla, the monkey boy. And, of course, my partner and my friend for almost 23 years, a guy who makes me laugh more than anyone I've ever known, Todd Clark Pettengill. And most of all, thanks to the people who make this all worthwhile. I'm talking about the people listening to us right now. Radio listeners who have supported me for so many years. And believe me when I say I love all of you and I cherish my relationship and the relationship we've had for so many years. It's been a great ride, my friend. That's all I got. So one more time, I got to say thank you and bye, buckaroos.
There's some kind of connection between us and the people who listen to the radio.
Yeah.
And in the past, I don't know, month, mm-hmm. since we announced the situation, we've gotten so many emails, and I got more snail mail in the past 2 or 3 weeks than I ever got the whole time we were here.
Well, everybody emails or they message you.
I got them on my desk. And yeah. Some people go through the whole relationship mm-hmm. and talk about all the things that we've done and what we've meant to them, and different people going through. There was one lady who went through breast cancer with Patty at the same damn time.
A lot of people like that, yeah.
And I was going to take some of these notes and share them on the air, but I
you're too emotional.
I don't think I could.
I know.
But I do want to say thanks to Louisa McGuinn and Laura Tomasco.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them had just beautiful notes.
Oh, different types. So many.
I don't want to. I just couldn't bring myself to try to read those. After I was going to do it, and I think, well, how am I going to do that?
Well, we're still going to be there. We're still on social media. You can still reach out to us, and that way you can also find out what comes next.
The other day we had a lady call, and her name was. I should know her name because it's the same as our producer.
Heather,
and her name is Pfefferman.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I believe had an F, right? Not
yes.
Pfefferman, but
yes,
Pfefferman.
Mm-hmm.
And she wrote, and she's a school teacher,
mm-hmm.
but she wrote and recorded a song about the show.
Yeah.
And it was pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, and we
sounds like an indie artist, like, you know, like an independent. It's really cool.
She kind of wrote the words and sang the song.
He's Michael Scott Shannon, been in radio a long time. He's fixing to retire, up the ladder he has climbed. For years he was our champion, he was such a force. He's been in the game, he made a name. He loves baseball, enjoys football, spends time on the golf course. Super Shan's got Shannon, been from sea to shining sea. To Nashville, Atlanta to D.C. Had a station in Tampa, he created the morning zoo. To New York he came to Z100 fame. They were the worst, he took them into first. It was his career breakthrough. He's DJ Scott Shannon, went to a station in L.A. He came back to the East Coast to host mornings on PLJ. He landed his dream job at CBS 101. There was Scott and Patty, Brad Blanks, the Aussie. He's in the Hall of Fame, we'll remember his name. Now he and Trish can have some fun.
There you go. It's a nice little song.
Adorable, yeah. What a sweetheart.
You got Trish in there. How about that? Got a lot of those around there.
Right.
9:48 at CBS-FM. Last time around on the Big Show. I got to tell you something.
Yeah.
We're about out of time.
Yeah.
But I just want to tell you, Patty, it's been wonderful working with you. I got to know you better this time than all the other times.
Yeah, I always tell people I feel really blessed to have worked with you through three different incarnations. The Z100 Crazy Scott, the middle years at WPLJ, and now here. And it's been an evolution for both of us.
Yeah.
And I've loved every minute of it.
And who else would you like to thank today as we... now, Patty is not retiring. She wants you to know that. But she still has a... and most of her wonderful family is here today.
Yeah, my Jake is not here because he's out in Colorado. But I have Will here, my gorgeous 23-year-old. I have my spectacular 25-year-old daughter, Kate. And I have my fabulous... I can't remember how old he is, but my husband here, Steve.
Gorgeous. See, you sound like you watch that Wheel of Fortune. When they go on the Wheel of Fortune.
They tell that quick story about the family.
Nobody really has a normal husband or a normal child.
Right.
They're all like my awesome, fabulous 12-year-old
son.
Or my
really abnormal.
Who just got out of jail. No, you have a wonderful family and you are fortunate.
No, I do.
I announced it some time ago that... the run is over here at CBS-FM. When I came here, mm-hmm. I really thought that this was going to be my last job.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it didn't work out that way, but it was a great place to work.
Right.
And we had wonderful support for a long time. And I am going to take some time off and see how I like it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just don't want to make the mistake of coming back like poor Tom Brady.
And then not...
and throw interceptions. I don't want to do that, so... I
don't know. He's had his ups and downs. He's done not all right.
He came back and won a Super Bowl, Scott.
Right.
Yeah, no, I'm talking about recently.
All right.
You haven't been watching recently, obviously.
You know what? None of us want to do the recent things to be looked at.
Well... It's like I said, it's been fun. I'll continue my relationship with the station. On Sunday morning, we'll have the countdown, America's Greatest Hits. And if you like the oldies that CBS-FM used to play, like I do, mm-hmm. you know, the songs like the Four Seasons and the Beatles and the Rolling Stones and the Motown, I got a channel called the True Oldies Channel, and it runs on a 101.1. That's HD3.
Thank you.
And it's, you know, also available online. You might like it because it hardly got any commercials. So that's kind of nice.
Not and, for you, it's not.
No, but it's built that way.
No, I know. I'm kidding.
So I want to say thanks to my wife and my daughter, Kathleen. They've been through many difficult times with me. And I'm so proud.
Hello, but not just difficult. How many beautiful, incredible times have they been through? Exciting times.
Well, it's called For Better or For Worse. Remember that?
Yeah, and keep in mind, you know, I can't even imagine what it must be like for them to live all these years with this icon of our business. So,
well,
lucky
I'm not
them.
An icon at the house.
No, you are. They just don't tell you.
I still get the call. Dad, pick me up at the airport in a hurry.
Yeah. No, I know. That, but. And I want to say thank you to you, Scott, because you've been through a million ups and downs with me. Everything from, you know, difficulties in my life to up times. You were at my wedding. You've been in at the hospital seeing new babies. You've been a really huge part of my entire adult life. And my husband here, too. I mean, you introduced him to big time radio. So, you know. I love you.
I love the whole family.
Yeah,
I'm stuck with you guys.
Yeah.
Thank you to Heather. Done a great job today.
We love you.
Hello, Heather.
Heather's really been a gem. I miss you, Joe Nolan. Sue Al, I got to thank her for her service. John Elliott, who we dearly love.
Our precious John.
Dan Taylor, who was so nice when I got here and was so helpful to me.
Mr. G?
His brother, Race Taylor. Wow. My friend from the Radio Hall of Fame. I love this guy, Broadway Billy.
Yeah.
One of those guys with a big heart. Joe Causey, thank you. Mm-hmm. Dave Stewart. Dermot O'Neill, down right next door.
Wonderful guy.
Great guy. Jim Ryan, one of the guys that hired me here. Chris Olivero, who kept me here for a while. Don Belucas, who was here running things.
Mm-hmm.
And
Scott Herman.
Yep, Scott Herman. John McConnell, thank you for all you do.
David Katz, my guy.
Yeah. See, you didn't have a list like I did. You're thinking of one here.
No, it just
pops popping.
In. Jackie Alderman, who's always been our right hand here.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Jackie!
We will miss you. We love you for listening. And bye, buckaroos.
Perfect.
Woo!
And now the end is near. And so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words.
was mine.
WCBS-FM and WCBS-FM HD1.
It's all I listen to.
New York's greatest hits.